Hello friends, I am Rashmi Sharma. In this video, we are going to start with the final chapter of ICT, that is recent developments related to ICT. So these are the contents that has been given in IES 2019 for chapter 6. So I will make sure that you will be clear with the basic idea behind every concept, so that you will be clear with what can be the answer. I may not have solved so many problems based on that, but the basic concept of things would be made clear in these videos for this chapter. So the very first is artificial intelligence, then evolved edge technology, holographic storage, HBD, HTML 5.0, quantum computing, Stuxnet, big data, and net neutrality. I will make sure that all the ideas behind this contents would be made more clear. So the very first, let's start with artificial intelligence. So according to McCarthy, the definition is like the science and engineering of making intelligent machines, especially intelligent computer programs. So as we know, human beings can see something, learn from it, and take its decision. So the same as human beings, the machines are made to think, are programmed so that they would be able to take their own decisions. They are trained by showing different things. They are trained by making the code so that they would be able to adapt something new. Everything they would learn from the decision. Basically, how human beings think, learn. For example, there is a child. He would see some fruits. His parents show him different kinds of fruits. They show him this is apple, this is banana, this is cake. They show him different fruits, and they from that there's some memories kept in his mind. And then when the next time the same fruit appears in front of his eyes, he's able to take the decision that okay, this is this fruit. So the same way the intelligent systems, the machines are to be trained by showing them different kinds of things. They are trained, and from that they would learn something and would be able to take their decisions, what the thing might be or what the thing is. So artificial intelligence is nothing but to train the machines and make them think intelligently. So the software is coded in such a way. So what are the goals of artificial intelligence? It is to create expert systems. What I have said just now, as human beings take, learn, demonstrate, explain, and advise its users or the people who come in contact, the same thing the machines are made to do by using some coding, by using some programming. They are programmed in such a way. And another goal is to implement human intelligence in machines. That is by creating systems to understand, think, and behave like human beings. So we will see, as we know, the artificial intelligence is one of the very broad or wide area, we can say. So which are the things that might be contributing to artificial intelligence? See, there are so many sectors that are contributing. The machines may think like a human being. It itself declares that there comes a part of computer science, there comes a part of neurology, since it is completely related with brain. And there comes the part of biology, there comes the part of sociology, there comes a part of psychology, all these things. So here it is clear that the clearly given which are the sectors that are contributing to intelligent systems. So how neural science might be contributing, it is simple. The way human brains think, like the neurons are accepting something, and they are processing the data, they are keeping the memory. All these things are implemented into intelligent system, the complete neural network, the artificial neural network works same as the human neural network system. So this is the main sector, we can say. The computer science, this is one of the important sector because all this machines are made intelligence and computer systems comes under the computer science part. Then mathematics, all the algorithms, everything that originates to something new or discovers something, the base of that is mathematics. So the algorithms, whatever are the back propagation algorithm, probability statistics, all that comes under mathematics part. Psychology gives answers of few things like can machines really act as intelligent as human beings? Can they solve the problems as human beings do? Can machines have mind, mental state, and can it really feel like the human beings do? So all these questions that arise and that are answered, that comes under the philosophy part. So there are so many sectors. All these sectors contribute to intelligence system some way. So see friends, I'm trying to make you clear with the basic idea behind artificial intelligence so that you will get to know what exactly artificial intelligence is. So here we must see what would be the thing with artificial intelligence and without artificial intelligence. For example, there is a program that is not containing artificial intelligence part. So it would be like a computer program without AI can answer specific question. For example, if some program is trained to do addition, it would do addition. Like, it is program specific. It would not be able to do something really intelligently. That, for example, it would see the some numbers are there. It would be able to do, by learning something, it would be able to perform action. It will not happen without artificial intelligence. So programming with AI is like a computer program with artificial intelligence can answer generic question. That it is equations that it is meant to solve. More generalized thing is like artificial intelligence covers. So modification of program leads to change in its structure. For example, when we do coding in C, if we want to change something in the code, it changes its structure. But when it comes to artificial intelligence programs can absorb new modifications by putting highly independent pieces of information together. See, highly independent pieces of information. So for example some code does this part, some part of code does this, some part of code does this, but all these things are independent of each other and those are merged together and so as to form the artificial intelligence. So hence you can modify even a minute piece of information of program without affecting its structure. Next is modification is not quick and easy. It may lead to affect the program adversely in case of programming without AI. But in case of programming with AI, it is quick and easy program modification. So let's see what exactly is artificial intelligence technique. So in the real world, knowledge has some unwelcome properties. For example, see, as every day we are uploading some data on internet, we are uploading some pictures on Facebook, we are uploading we are sending something by WhatsApp. So every day we are using abundant on internet. And this volume is really huge and it is some random data. It is not very organized data. So the volume is huge next to unimaginable. Consider what is the population of India. Consider what is the population of world. So all the people are collecting the data, putting it on internet. So this complete data is unimaginable. So it is not well organized and well formatted. It keeps on changing constantly. So these are the challenges in front of the developers, the handlers. So artificial intelligent technique is a manner to organize and use knowledge efficiently in such a way that it should be perceivable by people who provide it. It should be easily modified to correct errors. and it should be useful in many situations, though it is incomplete and inaccurate. Artificial intelligence elevate the speed of execution of complex program it is equipped with. See, if the data is not organized, definitely it would require more time to solve any problem. But if if something is done so that the huge data is organized in such a way that it is consuming less time as compared to the previous, it would be really very efficient. So let's see in what are the domains or sectors in which artificial intelligence is used nowadays. So applications of artificial intelligence. The very first is gaming. So as we know, GPUs are mainly used for gaming purposes. The very fast running games are run on GPUs, using GPUs. So gaming is first sector. So artificial intelligence plays crucial role in strategic games such as chess, poker, tic-tac-toe, etc., where the machine can think of large number of possible positions based on heuristic knowledge. The next is natural language processing. See, as we speak in English, Hindi, Marathi, or whatever your language is, the computer does not understand that language. And if we want the computer to understand our language, the natural language processing comes under. So yet there are so many machine learning algorithms, or we might say there were so many progresses that has been done yet for natural language processing. And nowadays artificial intelligence is taking part. So it is possible to interact with the computer that understands the natural languages spoken by the human beings. So whatever human beings will speak, the intelligence system will capture that whatever the voice is, and it would convert that into the digital form that the machines would understand, the computer system would understand, and so that we would be able to communicate with the computer systems directly. The next is expert systems. So there are some applications which integrate machine software and spatial information to impart reasoning and advising. So they provide explanation and advice to the users. Then the vision systems. This system understand, interpret, comprehend visual input on the computer systems. For example, spying aeroplane takes photographs which are used to figure out spatial information of the map areas. For example, in remote sensing, what is done? The first image of some particular area is taken, and after some time, after some duration, the image of same area is taken, and the when we subtract the first image from second image, we would get to know what is the difference that has occurred from the first situation to the second situation, and that would be able to detect the changes that have happened. You might have seen the movie Pamanu, in that the thing is used. So doctors use clinical expert system to diagnose the patient. And see, tumor detection algorithms nowadays, the artificial intelligence thing is widely used in medical imaging. So police use computer software that recognize the face of criminal with stored portrait made by forensic artists. So see, artificial intelligence nowadays in using biometrics, for example, in medical imaging, I have said. Then remote sensing techniques, the very first. So thief detection, for example, there are as we know, the fingerprint detection, the face detection, all these things are nowadays efficiently used by using artificial intelligence. Is the face detection algorithms yet so far has been done using machine learning techniques, but nowadays artificial is also contributing a lot to face detection, so that the security system is really becoming very promising. So next is speech recognition. Some intelligence systems are capable of hearing and comprehending the languages in terms of sentences and their meanings while human talks to it. It can handle different accents, slang words, noise in background, change in humans' noise due to cold. So speech recognition is being something really intelligent, like it is filtering all those the things that are not that should not be there. For example, background noise is there. For example, slang words are there. So it is automatically detecting what the human beings wants to say. So this is really a leading thing. Then handwriting recognition. So handwriting recognition, like not only English but Sanskrit and Marathi words are also being detected by using. Yet all these fields were dominated by machine learning, and nowadays deep learning is taking a part in like handwriting recognition, speech recognition, natural language processing, medical image processing, all these things. Yet machine learning was dominant, and nowadays deep learning is taking the part. And intelligent robots is like robots are able to perform the task given by humans. They have sensors to detect physical data from real world, such as light, heat and temperature, movement, sound, bulb, bump and pressure. All these things the robot can is nowadays able to feel. They have efficient processors, multiple sensors and huge memory to exhibit intelligence. In addition, they are capable of learning from their mistakes and they can adapt new environment. So we can say this was the first part where we have seen what exactly artificial intelligence is, how it is contributing, in which domains it is contributing. In brief, we will see what machine learning is, what is deep learning, if the time permits. So we will continue with the chapter in the next video. Thank you.